Okay? So what do we do with this value? Well, what this means, okay, and by the way, as I said earlier, the discount rate can be the required return instead of the bank rate. Okay, I explained that already. Okay, so now what do we do with this value? Well, we find out that the stock value is only, or the stock value, or the stock fair value is only $23.17. But it is now selling in the stock exchange at $24 per share. So what this means is that the market price of $24 is a little bit expensive. So maybe it's not a good idea to buy it at $24 because its fair value is only $23.17. Okay? So just remember that, okay? Now, I already said this one a while ago. Expected return is not the same, okay, as deposit rate. So this thing here, this 11%, sometimes it's called required return, sometimes it's called expected return. Okay? You can check that out more in the CAPM video if you like, and it's free as well. I have a free video on CAPM, or the capital asset pricing model, which computes the expected return. All right. Next slide. Okay, what if the same stock's dividends will grow by 3% per year? What will be the new value of this stock now? So the old value is, okay, $23.17. But this value will be different if the stock dividends will grow by 3% per year. So first of all, let's look at the dividends for each year. The dividend in the first year, as you remember from the first, from the last slide, is $2 per year. But the dividend in the second year, okay, so this div 1 just means dividend in the first year. Your dividend in the second year will be the same $2 times 1.03, because it grows by 3%, and we use the future value formula. So your dividend in the second year will be $2.06. Now our dividend in the third year will be $2.06 multiplied by 1.03, because it grows by 3%. So our dividend in the third year will be $2.12. Okay? So now we use the same net present value formula which we used in the last slide. Okay? However, now we change the values of the dividends. Here it's $2, $2.06, $2.12, and then we still get the $25 when we sell the stock after the end of 3 years. So now, what is the new stock value using the net present value formula? It is $23.30. Okay? So the old one, okay, the old price, okay, or the original price is $23.17 if the dividend stays the same every year for 3 years. But now that the dividend is growing, the stock value, the fair value, is a bit higher. It is now $23.30. It's a bit higher because now your dividend is growing, and of course it's much nicer to have a dividend or cash which is growing. Okay? So it's higher than when it was not growing in the last slide. Right? Next. What if the dividend stayed at 2% per year, but you plan to keep the stock forever and not sell it? Okay? The discount rate is 11%, as we already know. Okay? For this one, we use the perpetuity formula, okay? As you can remember. So it looks like this. Okay? It is very simple, which is the dividend amount divided by the discount rate. That's all there is to it. It's so simple. Dividend amount divided by the discount rate. And that will give us $18.18. Okay? So if you plan to, if this stock is earning $2 per year in dividends for you, and you will not sell the stock after 3 years, like in the first example, and you plan to keep the stock forever, you will not benefit from the $25 that you will get if you sell the stock after 3 years, right? So if you will not benefit from that $25 at the end of 3 years, then the only benefit for you is the $2 per year dividend. Okay? So if you only benefit from the $2 per year dividend, then we compute the value of this stock for you as $2 dividend divided by the discount rate, and you get $18.18. Okay? So, there we have it. Alright, so what if, okay, now what if the dividend starts out at $2 per year and will grow by 3% per year, and you plan to keep the stock forever and not sell it, okay? And the discount rate, as we know for this example, is 11%. Okay, now we use this formula. The stock value is equal, or the fair stock value, okay, is equal to, hold on a second, the dividend divided by the discount rate, which is 11%, minus the growth rate, which is 3%. So that gives us our $2 dividend in the first year, okay, divided by 11%, or 0.11, minus 0.03, which is 3% growth rate, and that gives us $2 divided by 0.08. So now the stock value to you is $25. All right? So in this case, if you remember, in the market, the stock was being sold for $24. So if it's being sold in the market for only $24, but the fair stock value to you is $25, then that means it's good to buy it at $24, because the stock is worth more than $24 to you. It is actually worth $25 to you.